Yo, what's going on, guys? It is Fox United here. Welcome back to a brand new video for you guys today here on the channel. And today we are back with my F1 2020 my team career mode here for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And obviously we're going to be looking to bounce back in this episode. If you guys haven't checked out the previous episode, I recommend you go and check that one out before you go and head over and continue watching this video, as I'm going to be spoiling what happened in the last episode. So you've had your time. Basically, in the last episode in Monaco, we were running in P5, and then Max Verstappen took us out of the race at Massenet, which was really, really frustrating. But we're here for Azerbaijan, and I actually forgot that Azerbaijan was much, much later in the calendar compared to where it normally is. Normally it's like round 4 or something like that of the season. This time now it's round 7, so a little bit of a change on that front. But of course, we're okay with that, and a lot of upgrades there. In fact, all the upgrades coming into place then for this Grand Prix weekend. So that will be awesome. As you can see then, we've got 4.82 million and in the bank, and we're sort of saving it, seeing what I really want to do with the finances. I was sort of debating it, but what we are going to do is go back to the power unit that we have been running since the Spanish Grand Prix. Not the Spanish Grand Prix. What was the Grand Prix that I took the penalty in? Whatever race I took the penalty in, we're going to go ahead and oh, it was the Dutch Grand Prix. Yeah, it was the Dutch Grand Prix that we took our penalties. So we're going to go back to that power unit now here for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, as the old power unit that we put in for Monaco is heavily worn, and yeah, we don't really need it. So yeah, short and short, get rid of it. We've now got our first major upgrade on the car, which is for the rear downforce. Can't remember if that was on the car already or not. We then are 4 resource points shy of a major chassis weight reduction, which we are going to put onto the car. I just need the resource points for it. And obviously, with us about to go into qualifying, we're going to have to complete qualifying and the race in order to gather those resource points in order for us to go ahead and place that upgrade onto the car. But nonetheless, we are here, and we're going to get ready for qualifying and see if we can keep up our good run of form. We've been on some good form recently, and Azerbaijan should suit the needs of this car. Of course, I have once again trimmed down the downforce on the car, so I'm running my own custom setup again, just to lower the wings and allow myself a little bit more straight line speed, as again, the car is decent in slow speed corners. If we cross the start finish line then, it's sort of only 3/10 of a second there off of Charles Leclerc's initial time, and I was really, really happy with that lap. And as we skip forwards through the session, away from the podium pass stuff, we got P7, and we only had to do one run in Q1, which was very, very satisfying. It meant that I have saved myself a set of soft tires to go for at least 2 runs in Q2, or maybe 1 in Q2 and then 2 in Q3. Who knows? But obviously, that's exactly what we wanted. A great run there, and Jack Aitken then fortunately misses out by a couple of hundredths, 2/100ths of a second actually. So yeah, still not good for Jack. It's Q2 then, and my first flying lap is coming towards an end here. I don't remember this flying lap being all that flying really, but we're coming towards the start finish line now. DRS is open as we continue on the long straight, which just doesn't seem to end. And yeah, it's 1:40.5 there. So that's not a good lap at all. We've definitely gone faster than that. So we're trying to try and improve. And as you can see, that's exactly what we're doing as we're crossing towards the start finish line now. I genuinely can't remember if that was a scrub set of soft tyres that I may have used in Q2 there, just to get a banker lap on the board and then enable to beat that on my Delta. But you can see that we're currently 8/10 of a second up on that previous best lap time. So as we cross the start finish line now, it's going to be a 1:39.6. Is that going to be enough to get us into Q3? Yes, it is. With P9 then, that is enough to get us into the third part of qualifying. For the third race in a row now, we make it into Q3. And really motoring now with my team, as I really start to understand this car extremely, extremely well, considering obviously using practice and stuff like that, and the fact that I got a little bit more top-end speed does give me an advantage there. 9/10 of a second off of Lewis Hamilton, but Kimi Raikkonen, P2 in the Alfa Romeo, what have you had for your breakfast, and can I take a little bit of that, okay? Because that is ridiculously fast. You can see I'm hovering over there. I thought it was a Ferrari to begin with, and then I had to go back and double-check that. So, yeah, kudos to you for that. Moving then into Q3 then, and my only run in Q3, we set the fastest middle sector out of anybody so far in this qualifying session. That was a little bit of a surprise to myself there, but we'll have to see where we end up then. We're currently P10. I didn't do a banker lap in Q3. Maybe a bit of a mistake that I didn't, but nonetheless, we're coming towards the start finish line now. Let's see what lap time we can put together as we go along the straight. It's just foot flat to the floor now and across the start finish line. It was a 1:39.2, my best lap of the weekend, and it's good enough for P6 on the grid for the second race in a row then. Because we started P6 in Monaco, we'll get P6 here in Azerbaijan, and I cannot fault that in the slightest. It's 0.6 seconds behind Valtteri Bottas, but I'm not really bothered about the Mercedes and the Ferraris. What I'm bothered about is the fact that me in my forced career is really motoring now and mixing it up with the Red Bulls slightly. And I'm proud of that one as we now go to an interview with Claire, of course. She's been a bit of a prick recently, but let's see if she's any nicer. Are we happy with the grid? I'm satisfied. P6, pretty good. And I decided to go with a team acclaim for that one to try and help out on that front. And again, it asks me about how a team is performing, so I didn't really know. I just went with that. I don't know if that affects my team acclaim for the worse or for the better. Maybe in future I'll just ignore those questions and just tell her to go up herself and she could have a little bit of a puff again, because that stuff is funny. But yeah, as you can see, the rivalry breakdown, we've gone back ahead now, Pierre Gasly, after we were tied initially, and the team acclaim has gone up quite nicely due to us getting a strong qualifying result. Jack, though, still struggling a little bit, which is really frustrating to see. Of course, that is something that we need to address.
Welcome to Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. So let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90 degree corners through sector one lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through sector three towards the finish line. A warm welcome to Anthony Davidson, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Why don't we start by talking about Valtteri Bottas? That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Vettel, Hamilton, Max Verstappen, Thomas, Albon, Perez, Sainz, and Kimi Raikkonen. Stroll, Norris, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Gasly, Ocon, Ricciardo, Jack Aitken, and Daniel Kvyat, Grosjean, Magnussen, Russell, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
All right, so on the grid now to start the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And as you can see, it's going to be a one-stop race, starting on the soft tyres, pitting quite early for the hard tyres, but just taking them to the end of the Grand Prix. They've got the life to do it then. So as you can see there, we are on the grid then. We've got four, now five red lights here. And it's lights out. Here we go here to start the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. I can't talk for my life, but we get a good start nonetheless. So Albon gets a great start. Goes in towards turn one though. A little bit of contact there between Albon and Lewis Hamilton. And a bit of front wing there goes missing for the Red Bull driver. So after I failed to speak properly at the start of the Grand Prix, Albon already in trouble. He's going to be dropping back down the order. We've got a yellow flag then in the background there and towards turn two. But for us though, it's a clean getaway and we've managed to leapfrog Verstappen again. And we're back into P5 in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Does this give you any form of replicas of last round? I'll leave you to judge that one now. As we go towards there, we've been in contact actually though. Verstappen once again hitting the back of my car, but this time it was the full direct rear contact there. So Verstappen really costing himself dear there. He actually broke his front wing as well on that, and he had to pit for a second time. So once again, myself and Max Verstappen come to blows, and again, Max wants to hit the back of my car. I don't know what you've got against me, mate. Just because I'm Korean, is that what it's on about? I don't even understand. But lap six of the Grand Prix, positive signs in this Grand Prix. You can see that I'm sticking in DRS of the Ferraris, and I was quite surprised by my own pace. So we're coming in now for a set of the hard compound tyres, and our sights are firmly set in front of me rather than just holding station, maybe looking behind me. So on that front, I'm very, very satisfied with the first stint there, but it's only been 6 laps. We can't get too complacent. We're boxing now for a fresh set of the hard compound tyres, in and out in a jiffy. Good old Korean boys there. And we're going to get out. There was a lot of traffic, though, as we come out of the pits here. I think we're just going to rejoin side by side with the Haas and Kim and Magnussen. I need to stay in front of Magnussen. We're going to force him wide a little bit there. And we do rejoin in front of Magnussen. Fantastic stuff there. Now we've got the DRS here versus Romain Grosjean. Leclerc is trying to fight off Danny Capiat in the back, in the foreground there. So now we're going to try and make some inroads here. We're going to go down the inside gingerly on Romain Grosjean. Very easy now on this game, especially for me. If I break a little bit earlier to roll the car in mid-corner and exit, and I just get a better run there. Capiat gets phased a little bit by Charles Leclerc, and now we're going to try and take advantage of that as we go now into his middle sector. Difficult braking zone this one, especially when I'm trying to outbrake Capiat with Leclerc turning in on me there, but we make it stick and we're back in front of Capiat. Next up is Charles Leclerc, and then it's my teammate Jack Aitken. Onto lap 8 of the Grand Prix now, and coming out of the pits here, it's going to be Sebastian Vettel, and the undercut then has worked against the Ferrari man. So Vettel stopped one lap later than me and Leclerc did, and the undercut has worked beautifully there. So I'll take that any day of the week. Now onto lap 8 of the Grand Prix here, we've got a fight going on up front with Lewis Hamilton fighting one of the Toro Rosso, Alfa Tauris, I want to say it is. Then it's Lando Norris, then it is Jack Aitken, then it's Leclerc, and then it's myself. So let's see what we can do now. We're banging on with the ERS here as we go down the long motorway straight here. Vettel is passing Pierre Gasly, I think it's all, it's Grosjean actually. As we now are chasing up to our teammate Aitken now. Aitken goes defensive in towards the turn one. We're going to go down the inside though into the first corner and make the overtake stick on our teammate there. And that relegates Jack Aitken down a position there as his medium compound tyres start to fade away as our fresh hard tyres really start to warm up now. But Leclerc is onto the back of Lando Norris here for position. Hamilton has overtaken the AlphaTauri. But speaking of Charles Leclerc, we're going to go down the inside of the Ferrari man. Be opportunistic here and make the move stick on the Ferrari man. And that is now going to be a net P3 in the Grand Prix as the Mercedes men were in front of us in this race. So that is beautiful stuff there from ourselves as we now press onwards in this Grand Prix with Lando Norris next. Then it is Pierre Gasly. But so far, we're making our way through the traffic very, very nicely versus the AIs. We're doing a better job of it than what they are. Now as we go in towards the castle section here versus Pierre Gasly and Lando Norris. Of course, Norris is going to get the DRS on Gasly. We're going to get the DRS on Norris here. So we really need to make sure that we're in prime position to attack here. But now we're going to be using a little bit of ERS, but we're gaining a little bit in this slipstream now as we're attacking towards this corner now with Lando Norris. Norris breaks extremely early for this corner. We have to take a lot of curb there to make that move stick. And I think we were just about okay for track limits there, but Norris does in fact creep in front of us for about a tenth of a second, if that. So yeah, we'll accept that one. Now onto the problem that we've got though. Even though we may have made that overtake and you can question track limits, I think we were just about in it. Our problem now is this long motorway straight. Yeah, Norris is going to have the DRS back on me now, so that was a little bit clumsy. I probably should have been a little bit patient there, as now Lando Norris is going to open up that DRS. He's going to go for it. Leclerc is going to go for it as well here. We're going to have to defend against both Norris and Charles Leclerc. Towards the outside line goes Lando Norris. We'll defend the inside line. Norris just briefly gets ahead, but we'll break later than the Britishman and get in front of him there and retain P7 in this Azerbaijan Grand Prix as we're negotiating all these traffic members here. Crucially though, these guys are all starting on the hard tyres, so I wonder if they're going to go hard to soft towards the end of the Grand Prix, which would be quite interesting. But it just means that they lose a lot on our compared to our fresh hard tyres here. As Pierre Gasly now, who's actually my rival, remember, I selected him at the start of the season to be my rival, and of course Gasly there gets a little bit wayward on the exit of the corner there, and that's not going to help him out in the slightest. But now all of a sudden you can see now we've got DRS here. Lando Norris is getting passed by Charles Leclerc, so if I want to continue to build my gap away from Leclerc, I've got to pass Gasly here. And the straight now, we're getting very, very close, and again we can just brake and just let the car roll on through into the first corner, and that is an overtake done on Gasly. And now Leclerc will have to fight him as Lewis Hamilton is taking on Esteban Ocon for P4 in this Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Ricciardo is up next. Lap 12 of the Grand Prix now. We've got 1 second gap over Gasly. Leclerc still hasn't passed Pierre, actually. But for us, we'll continue to press on ourselves. Bottas there is out of the Grand Prix, and out comes the safety car to go with it then. And Albon is also out of the Grand Prix. And we're going to skip a little bit further. There's a jump cut there. I was trying to catch a replay cam, and I never actually got to it. George Russell now is out of the Grand Prix as well. So, yeah, big shock. So actually, that jump cut was, I was going to try and get an instant replay cam. I couldn't get it. Oh, that's why Bottas is out of the Grand Prix. He's lost it at the DRS then. And he's just spun and gone nowhere. So how did Albon and Russell go out of the race? I'll tell you how they went out of the Grand Prix. So we'll start with Alexander Albon here. So he's onto the start-finish straight now. And the yellow flag is out at this stage, and I was looking at the back of the Red Bull, seeing if there's anyone behind. So there's no one behind here. Bottas is out of the... What is you... Oh, my God. What is Alex Albon doing? Oh, and that's where Russell's come involved in this as well, to get into the back of him. Albon has literally just attacked Bottas. He is just... What has he done? Bottas is retired. He's on the middle of the pit straight. Albon has just turned his car into the direction of Bottas and just smashed into him. I have never seen that in a Formula One game ever, when an AI has just turned it. Albon, mate, are you good? Do you think that was Lewis Hamilton and you wanted to just try and kill him? You got the wrong Mercedes driver to start with, but oh God, Jesus alive. Anyway, lap 14 of the Grand Prix now. Safety car's back in. Hamilton gets on with it. But Hamilton, he is not using his ERS on the exit. In towards the first corner. And then lap 15 of the Grand Prix will go down the inside of Lewis Hamilton and make it stick on the Mercedes driver. And we're into the lead of the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Caught Hamilton napping then off the restart. He didn't use any ERS then. I thought he would, but he didn't. So we take the lead then. And now onto lap 16 of the Grand Prix. Now it's time to go onto the defensive here. The Koreans have been on the attack all race long. Now it's time for the Koreans to plant up the barricades, e.g. my car, and go on the defensive. Hamilton here has got a great run off the exit of the left and right corners, but Hamilton there not really going for it onto this attack. Leclerc's the one that's going for it now, and towards the outside line here, using up as much of the ERS as possible now into the first corner. DRS has now been enabled, and now as we defend it towards the first corner, all I've got to do is get the braking zone right, which we do, and that is the position defended. Now it's going to be Charles Leclerc who's going to be my challenger in this Grand Prix as we fend it off Lewis Hamilton. Leclerc gets through, back end slides a little bit though on the exit of turn two. Now on towards the start finish, not the start finish, what the hell am I on about? This is the back straight here. Leclerc now with the DRS here. He's gonna get in front, but again, I could just brake a little bit earlier slash later and let the car roll through and we maintain track position. But on lap 17 of the Grand Prix now, it's quite clear that we're gonna be in for a scrap to the finish line, but the barricades are up here in Korea. And now, as you can see, we are now trying to blast our way through and make some ends here. As you can see now, Leclerc is trying to use a bit more pace in his car. He opens up the DRS to try and access a little bit more straight line speed from that Ferrari. We're just using the battery and rich mixture here to attack with Charles Leclerc. Vettel now trying to go around the outside. I've noticed that I've had to brake a little bit deep in towards turn one, but crucially, it was enough to hold off against Sebastian Vettel now. Leclerc has dropped down the order behind there. Seb tried to go for it there. Did you see that in towards turn two? Tried to dive it, and now he's lost time there. And crucially, lap 19 to start lap 20, the gap is 1.2 seconds. We've now broke DRS from these guys, which is crucial. It's one of the Renault cars there slowing down. And oh, there's a second safety car. Oh, that is a safety car that I just could have done without. Really could have done without that safety car. One of the Renault cars, as we skip all of that, slowed down on the start-finish straight. We just broke DRS from Leclerc and Vettel there. And it could have been great as they were scrapping with each other. But now, that's all gone away because now we're onto the start-finish straight here. I've bolted away a little bit early, used my ERS, but crucially, on the restart here in Azerbaijan, none of the AIs used the ERS, which is clear to see how I got past Hamilton so easily when I was using my ERS. But yeah, as soon as I noticed that they weren't using it, well, I stopped using it because what's the point? As now we go in towards turn two here, trying to get the best run now. We've got four laps though to get to the finish line. Lap 23 now, which will start lap 24. Leclerc is just 0.3 seconds back. Then it's Sebastian Vettel. Giovinazzi is up in P4 for Alfa Romeo. So fantastic stuff from him there as Leclerc gets very close to the back of the rear wing now as we press onwards down the straight here, not using the ERS. Crucially, I'm waiting until they're around about side by side, like now, to use my ERS because there's no point in using it whilst they've got the slipstream because it just gives them an extra boost. And I'd rather they didn't have that. So I'm tactically waiting to use the ERS at the points where I know I've got to use it. But now onto the straight here, you can see Leclerc is going to get that DRS. So it's going to be crucial that I hold my inside line here to stop Leclerc from getting anywhere near me. But with the DRS now, he's going to press onwards, but closing the door in towards turn three, getting a little bit deep through there. Leclerc might just sniff an opportunity, but we managed to fend off against him. Lap 24 now to start lap 25. The gap is 0.6 seconds now. A little bit wayward, actually, through there. The tyres are actually in decent nick, in fairness to them. I didn't think they'd go this long, but they clearly are now. As Leclerc, though, is going to absolutely fly past us here with that DRS wide open. Now, of course, We are using our battery to try and defend against the Ferrari man as Leclerc goes on past. But again, we can just be very smart with the way that I pile onto the brakes here. Let that car roll into the corner. As Leclerc's not going to cover the inside line, I'll just take it. Thank you very much then. As we start lap 25, just two more laps to go in this Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And we are fighting really, really hard. The engine there is overheating. Noticing that, I was running the car in rich mixture constantly to try and stop the Ferraris. But in hindsight, I need to put it back into standard, which I did. Let the engine cool down, which means I'm going to get better straight line speed performance now on the start-finish rate. Lewis Hamilton is also gaining on a series. He's managed to find his way past Antonio Giovinazzi finally. And now we're using our battery as much as we possibly can here. Leclerc is not as close as he has been, but of course, we've been working with this inside line, so I'm going to keep defending the inside line. Leclerc now goes towards the outside line here. This is the final lap of the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. We now defend down the inside. It looked a little bit late there on the brakes, but it worked out for us. Back end slides a little bit there. I spot that. Leclerc's going for it now. He's clearly using his ERS in some unorthodox places, and it goes for it around the outside of turn two, and I'm fine with that because I'll just defend the outside of turn two. Now I'm towards the run towards turn three here. Leclerc is going to have a little run of us here. Unfortunately, wheel spin covered my, lost my entry and exit into that last corner, but we do defend into turn three as we're doing everything we can. Lewis Hamilton is involved in this scrap at lap 26. Towards the end of it now, we've just got this straight to go. The gap is half a second now as we come towards the start-finish line here. Gap down 0.4 seconds. Leclerc is super close now to the back of my rear wing. We have to just hold on here, giving it everything we've got. Leclerc is not using his ERS. We're now half a second clear as we go towards the start-finish line. It's going to be our second race win of the season here at Azerbaijan. And for that one, that was not due to AI bugs. That was due to pure luck, really, and some fantastic defensive driving there from myself today. And all I can do is credit where credit is due, really. In that Grand Prix, where did I manage to win that Grand Prix? Well, first things first, I've got past the AIs when they were stuck in traffic. We were much more aggressive than the AIs, trying to make our way through the traffic, and we got past them. The likes of Leclerc, we overtook whilst they were, we were in traffic, and I was building clear. As soon as the safety car came out and Bottas was out the equation, I was already up into a net P2. Shout out to my celebration, by the way. Yeah, do that dance, boy. But yeah, as soon as I got up into P2, on the restart then, like I said, no one used ERS, so as soon as I used my ERS, Hamilton was a sitting duck. There was nothing he could do, and we went down the inside into turn one, and from that point onwards, as soon as I was in the race lead, all I had to do was just defend. You know, I could run my own race through the entirety of the lap, and when they were going to get onto my back, which was the start-finish straight, all I had to do was manage my ERS, manage my fuel, defend the inside line, it worked for me, and get the braking points right to turn one. I did all of that, and we managed to win the race. If the safety car hadn't had come out, we probably would not have won the Grand Prix. Hamilton would have definitely won, but we managed to get past him. Drivers' Championship then, the gap is 1 point between Leclerc and Vettel now, so that's quite fascinating. Hamilton, 28 points off the lead, with Bottas, 24 points off the lead. But the race, like I said, it was just down to pure luck and strategy. And of course, as well, what also helped with luck, as we look at the Constructors' Championship here for P4, I'll talk about my other thing in just a second, because we can have an interview with Claire in Oma Memento, e.g. now. Let's see what she's got to say then. So, first things first, she was talking about cutting through the field. That was down to the power unit. We were much, much quicker than the others in a straight line, probably because I helped, because I had a little bit of a setup running. That kind of helped me out. In terms of things looking up, I didn't really know what to praise there, because the only way was up, considering I got taken out of the Grand Prix, so yeah, that's a bit awkward. I was really, really happy with the car, in general. Don't know where I crashed. I mean, Verstappen went into the back of me, so you can shove that one up your microphone, and that is everything for that front. But as I was saying, though, the other bit of luck I got is Albon dove it down the inside of turn one. He broke his front wing. That put him out of the equation. Verstappen then hit the back of me, broke his front wing, put him out of equation. So automatically, both Red Bulls are out of the equation. We had the pace over the others because the Red Bulls were holding up the drivers of the first stint. And then, like I said, everything went our way in that Grand Prix. In Monaco, it went badly for us. Here in Azerbaijan, everything went my way. If one thing didn't go my way, we weren't winning that Grand Prix. It's as simple as that. But we also get a massive haul of cash, which is so desperately needed after our disaster at Monaco, and that puts us at 5.98 million. Your boy is rich out here in the land of North Korea. You should come down some often if we don't shoot you for being here, because we've got a lot of money, and we're not giving it to you. Back in towards the team headquarters now then, and we can have a little bit of a debrief, and that is exactly what we need. So we're going to do that now, see how we can get on then. So let's see if we can try and do any upgrades. Obviously, we've got a lot of money, so we should be able to potentially invest that. But I do know that there is a driver market mid-season, and I am thinking about that quite heavily, I'll be perfectly honest. Hey, look, it says June the 8th on a Monday. Shout out to that being my birthday. Enough about that. We're having a look at the facilities now, and I was having a look at all this stuff here, what I wanted to do, and I decided to do a sponsor event for extra team acclaim there. But having a look at the R&D tree, we've now got enough to upgrade the chassis. So we are going to do that. It will arrive for the Austrian Grand Prix. So we will not get it for the Canadian Grand Prix or the French Grand Prix. It'll have to be with the Austrian Grand Prix, but that's completely fine. I'm down for that. And we'll pop that onto the car. And I don't believe I share anything else in this episode. So guys, if you have enjoyed today's episode, feel free to drop it a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new around here as well. We're seriously moaching in this career mode. And as the races go on, I'll start to get a bit more experience and I can start racking up the AI level a little bit more. Because, of course, we obviously want to continue to make it that extra little bit of a challenge. So, yeah, I will see you guys next time. Take care all. Peace.